Okay, the product recommendation is that you wear gloves when you're mixing and handling the product. Now, I'm going to make a few of these tops to show you just how fun and easy it is. So before I put the A and B mixture together, I want to make sure I kind of, you know, an idea of how much of the product I'm going to be needing. So we will do one of the reef coral tops. We'll do some of the coral, and we'll do a finial. And I'll choose this finial, and I'll put this in one of the bottle tops too, and show you some really fun things that you can do with these. So I want to make sure I have enough of the product, and if I have to make more, that's okay. If you have leftovers, believe me, you can find something that you can make with it right away. Whether you make a little journal cover or you just work on another bottle. These get very addictive. So you want equal amounts of the A and the B mixture. And usually when you work with this for a while, you start to get a pretty good eyeball sense of the parts. I just roll them in balls and it's usually easier to see. So those look pretty even. So you want to mix the epoxy until it's all one color. Usually takes about 2 minutes to really get it mixed well. After you've mixed the epoxy sculpt, what you can do is just set it aside and just kind of leave it alone for a couple of minutes. It's a little bit sticky right after you've mixed it, so if you just set it aside for a few minutes, it'll start to harden just a little bit, not be so sticky. The bottle project that we're going to do first, the top is going to be a simple little coral coming up out of the bottle, and this will be a permanent seal. So if you wanted to put something in your bottle, this would be the time to do it, is right now. Next thing is you want to form a ball out of the epoxy sculpt, and what I usually gauge things by is I want the ball to be just a little bit bigger than the hole of the bottle. And then I tamp down on it with my fingers. And two things may be noticeable when you do this. One is you're going to get a little bit of what looks like a little belly button, an outie. And you want to push that down, that epoxy sculpt down with your finger, just until you see it go down into the neck of the bottle. That'll help get a nice adhesive seal. The next thing is you want to have sort of a button up here that's kind of goes around the rim of the bottle. That is assuming that you want a nice clean type of edge here. Then whatever it is that you're going to use, you can press it right in. So what you have here is you have what you just got, this putty looking type of a look right now. And what I want to do is I want to transform this to have it sort of become part, these two to become one and not look like two separate pieces. So the first thing I want to do, and that's why it's important to let this epoxy kind of set up a little bit, because if it's really sticky, you don't get the same ability to sculpt that you might get if you let it harden just a little bit. Just let it sit out for a few minutes. But just tamping it with my finger, see, with my instrument it's not really working as well. So I'm just going to use my finger to try to push the epoxy into the coral. When you have something organic like this, you'd like to have a look that's going to be more natural. Now, since the epoxy is still very soft, I'm going to just let it set a little bit longer before I go in and sculpt it a little bit, because it just feels just a little bit too sticky at this moment. And I'm going to go on to another bottle. The next one that I'm going to do is an old antique bottle. I think later I'll come back and put a varnish or something over this so that I can preserve the old label that's on it. And in this case, it's something that I can I can use a finial 4. I could also use a shell, which that might be pretty. I like the color. And I think that the crystal just might be a little bit too, it doesn't really fit that for me. So why don't I go ahead and put the shell on this? For the shell, I'm just going to use a smaller dime shape foundation, but I've pushed enough of it in that it is adhering to the inside of the bottle. So the epoxy has got a grip inside and along the top. And then I'm just going to maybe see which side I like best of the shell. I like that side. And I will push the shell in. There we go. Okay, and with my finger, I'm going to push the epoxy up against the shell and the glass so that it has something to adhere to and keeps this nice and solid as a joint here. Isn't that pretty? Okay, and now I'm going to set this one aside. The next one I'm going to do is this big boy. I've got this big bottle here, and this one is going to require more of the epoxy because it's a wider mouth. I'm not going to use that much where I would have this sitting because I'm going to do a different sort of trick. When the mouth of the bottle is that big, usually what I try to do is I'll do it in my hand a little bit and just get a little bit of a grip started on this. I want these to join a little bit closely to each other. That's what I was looking for. See, this is kind of hugging the other side of it. I just think that makes a prettier cluster. Oh, that actually worked out really perfectly. So now with my fingers, I'm going to again press onto the glass and make that connection nice and solid. I'm going to grab a little more of the epoxy and just press it right in and have it work itself over the coral and the bottle. Once that's done, I usually try to just then clean it up a little bit. And then press. You can also, at this stage, go in with something that's got a point to it, a toothpick, or this is a little sculpting tool I have had for a long time. And so you can just continue to find ways to really make this bond super, super, super tight, while also looking natural and part of the coral or whatever it is that you've chosen to be inside your top. Now as I move on to the finial is too wide for the opening of the bottle, so I need a quick little fix. And the easiest thing that I can do here is I can push a little bit of the epoxy into the hole because I have a screw, but it's too big. It would flop around in there. So I'm just trying to What I'm trying to do is build a way of surrounding this to give it some stick. I need to create a joint inside of the neck of the bottle, or if I just tried to plop this on top, as strong as the epoxy is, it's going to be a little precarious. It could fall off. So I'm going to go ahead and give myself a generous amount of the epoxy. And then when I put the epoxy sculpt in there, it'll give it just that little extra. And I'm trying to push it. It's kind of hard to see through these old bottles, but I'm trying to get a little extra epoxy down in there and fill that neck. And then I will go ahead and create a ball again. Push it down with my finger. And then when I push this through and everything sets, it's going to have a nice connection. And if I were to be very handy and very straight, I could remove the rest of this. There. It's a little tricky because I still want to create enough of a seam there so that it will hold. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to eyeball this to make sure everything is nice and straight, because once this cures, it's going to be rock hard. And if it was crooked, it's kind of going to stay like that. Now the crystal itself is a little wiggly, so that's just the way this is. I could put a little E6000 glue and make sure that it doesn't flop around. But you know what? That came out really, really well. Simple, easy. Look at that. And when it's cured completely, I'll show you how good that grip is. Now, you can't see the screw in there, but it's got something to hold on to now with that epoxy. And I could just decorate the neck of the bottle. You could do that if you push something through and you can see through it. You can decorate it and it'll, you know, it won't even show. So there we go. In just a simple few steps, we have done a single coral, multiple coral. We've done a shell. And we've done a finial. The next one I'm going to show you is how to create a cluster of crystals that you may enjoy doing as another really beautiful way to enhance the top of an antique bottle. I've mixed up the epoxy and I've let it rest for about 5 or 10 minutes. I do like to work with this on a little bit on the sticky side, so going to work with it right away is usually a good start. Depending on the size of the cluster or grouping that you want to make, bigger bottle, big grouping. Smaller bottle, smaller grouping. So I'm going to keep that in mind, and I'm just going to work on one of these smaller bottles. Same idea applies. Just push a ball right at the top so it forms the adhesion inside again, and you have a nice little stage or foundation to work on top of. This time I'm just going to push in the crystals, and as you do it you can kind of think about what you want your composition to look like and your arrangement. While I do this, I kind of work around in a circle and I leave the part in the center open. As you add more crystals, it gets a little trickier to keep everything in place. So you just kind of want to take your time. So as I work, I'm going to go closer and closer to the middle. And I'm going to try to camouflage as much of the epoxy as I can. So this is typically how I start out. Now, one important thing to remember is that these will move and not have really the best connection until you start to push the epoxy up into the rock itself. But I'm not ready to do that yet. I'm close, but not yet. The reason why is I'm going to stack up a little bit higher. I'm going to build it up just a bit higher. So I put like a pea-sized ball of epoxy in, and I can crown it with a bigger piece of the crystal and continue to add into the, it's like almost the petals of a flower. You just kind of want to see where you want to add more and more of the crystals. I think this is a pretty nice arrangement. And at this point, I'm going to take my gloves off. With a pointy instrument, now you're going to want to start pressing the epoxy into the rock. This is really important because now you want that epoxy to stick to the rock and really have a form a really tight seal on it, so it has something to grip. And at the same time, you can think about this formation having a foundation of more rock. So you can make an actual texture right onto it as you're working the epoxy into the crystal, and just give it a texture as if Mother Nature had created these crystals coming right out of the rock. You can pour some glitter in it later and give it that look of a geode or a glassy formation, something sparkly if you want to. But the functional part of what we're doing is making sure that that crystal has something to stick to so they don't fall off. What I find is to take your time and just try to make sure you've left no area looking like putty. You really want to disguise it and give it a natural look. So normally I would have an extra piece of the reef coral, and all I do is I just try to make impressions that match the coral pattern. And since this has had time to set up a little bit, it's not sticky, and I can easily create that sort of same finish here. How you do this is really your decision, but I'm just going to try and give you a couple of little ideas and inspirations. You can press sand into it, you can press pearls into it, you can have alternative types of coral coming up out of it. They're really, the sky's the limit on what you can do with this. So I have created this nice continuity between the coral and the epoxy sculpt. I pushed a couple of pearls inside too, which I think looks really cool. The beauty of nature is in its imperfections, so creating that makes this really fun because you don't have to be perfect at this. Just try to be consistent whatever you do. If you start with a pattern, just keep going until all of the epoxy sculpt is completely natural looking. So on this one, I actually want to build up a little bit of what could be the ocean floor. And so I created some cross hatches with a little X-Acto blade, and then that might look like the ripples of the sand, and this is just laying right inside of it. So I'm building a bit of a mound, and that can even overcome a little bit of the shell. When this is dry, it'll be snug as a bug. It'll stay right where it is. Okay, and so that really much does it. I have a lot of art journals hanging around because I'm always creating them. This particular art journal does not have any kind of embellishment. And so I thought it would be the perfect little project to complete my leftovers with. And so I'm going to show you simply what to do with your leftovers. If you have a small journal and you have a small amount of this left, or you want to do a journal page, you can create something with it. So what I'm going to first do is really flatten this out the best that I can. So So I'm just trying to push this out so that it really just covers the whole outside of my journal. In fact, I'm going to take a little bit of baby powder so that I can work it and just press it out. It smells good and it makes a really shiny, flat surface. And you can take out any potential air bubbles. You just want to really have this move. And I'm going to try to do this evenly if I can and get it right up to the fold of my journal. As I'm working it, I'm going to just use a little bit of water. Just getting my fingertips wet a little bit. Smooth it out. Just want to make sure that it really holds well. Want to make sure that I can turn my book. Make sure I can open and close. Okay. I have a rubber stamp, and if you covet your rubber stamps, you may or may not want to do this. I am going to do this and clean it right away and just wash it off. So I just put some baby powder on there. Okay. And I'm just going to take and give this a nice pressing. Once it's in there, I'll give it all the strength I've got. And when I pull it away, I have a really, really beautiful impression. So I'll go ahead and let this cure. In the meantime, I'm going to give my rubber stamp a nice washing, and we will go on to the next step.